Hi, this is Jennifer. It is Friday, June 2nd, and I'll talk about my tomatoes now. I have a lot of tomato plants, so I'll probably have to do this in a couple parts, maybe three. So first of all, I'd like to start out with my tomatoes that are now ripening. This is one of my Brandywine plants, and as you can see, the birds have been eating my tomatoes. So this plant has been attacked by blight and whatnot, but it still continues to press on. And now my biggest enemy are the birds. So what I've done to protect some of the other tomatoes that I would like to eat is cover them in these mesh bags that I got from Daiso. So basically these are laundry bags for lingerie. And it just so happens that they fit nicely over tomato clusters, and then you can zip them up a bit to keep them attached to the plant. And I've got some other type of mesh bags too, same purpose, from Daiso last year. This is the Less is Sweet Japanese. These two tomatoes here are almost ripe. I had a ripe tomato last week from this plant, and they were very good, very sweet. If you like sweet tomatoes, I recommend this plant. It seems to like being in ground instead of in a container or in a bed. And it also enjoys a bit of afternoon shade. So, yeah, this plant's been a challenge for me. And this is the first one I've got to grow robustly. Alright, on to some problem plants. So over here in this tomato bed, which is in ground, I'm having some problems with leaf curl. I should pull these plants such that the disease doesn't spread, but I can't bring myself to do it because I want to taste these fruits. So these are the speckled Roman, and other than these fruits, I don't think that this plant has produced any more viable flowers. So it just gets worse as it goes up the plant. Back here is a healthier speckled Roman. Yeah, it's blighted and all, but it's not. It doesn't have the leaf curl, and so there are some bigger fruits on it. And again, another speckled Roman with lots of bigger fruits on it. So as soon as these ripen, I will go ahead and pull this plant. My Cherokee plants also have leaf curl. Again, I'm just waiting for these to ripen, and then I'll pull the plants. The same over here. This one is a really big tomato, so I put it in a mesh bag to protect it from the birds. Anyhow, it's really sad what happened to these plants, but tomatoes grow quickly here. I'll just throw some more on the ground. Behind here is a black cherry tomato, which is ripening. And these back here are the San Marzano, which have got fruit on them now. And they're not very big for San Marzano, so that's kind of disappointing. But there are a lot of them. So, hopefully quantity makes up for the small size. And now onto my determinant bed. And here, the bison tomatoes are ripening. Those two, three might be ready to be picked. There's also some tomatoes back here that are ripening. I planted some new tomatoes up front. These are tiger tomatoes. The taxi and the Sprite tomatoes and the silvery fir have been removed. So the taxi tomatoes ripened and started falling. So I just pulled the plants and pulled off the tomatoes, and I've been eating those. The Sprite tomato, which is a great variety, turned out to be disgusting. So I pulled those. Waiting to taste the bison. What I've noticed so far is, other than the bush steak variety, I haven't liked any of the determinate tomatoes I've grown. They've all been either taste like grocery store tomatoes, or they've all been extremely sour tasting and acidic. So it'll be interesting to see whether these tomato varieties are any better. I'm especially concerned about the Supremo, which is supposed to be a Roma variety. I would really like them to taste good. But so far I haven't been having much luck with these determinate varieties. So I just tried one of the ripe cherry tomatoes off of that plant, and it was awful. Again, as sour as a lemon. No tomato we taste, just awful. I'll probably go ahead and pull that plant because that was gross. Alright, over here I have some more determinate tomatoes. This is my patio princess. It's got one tomato that's either ripe or close to being ripe. It's been doing pretty well. It has a ton of tomatoes on it. This one next to it is a fresh salsa, and looks like it needs some additional support. So let me go take care of that now. Okay, that's cleaned up a little with an additional steak. Back here is the anahu, and I'm not sure how tall this is supposed to keep growing, but it's starting to put out flowers now. So the tomatoes and the tomato planters have gone wild and are now overflowing the top of the planter. So right now my husband is making a bridge for the vines to cross, so there's additional support for all the tomatoes. The plants in here are quite happy. Have to do a lot of trimming though to keep the air moving through and to fight the fungus. So the bush steak here has some nice big tomatoes coming. Nice big handfuls. That one over there is even bigger. So I can't wait for these. These are great for sandwiches. You can also use, I also use them in sauce. This is one of my black crim. And it's got a little of a bite, of a blight too, but it's hanging in there. The Gladiator tomatoes, despite being very flimsy and thin, have got a few nice big tomatoes on them. And over here as well. Again, the Brandywines are doing quite well. They're spilling over, so tomatoes everywhere. I've got a bunch of tomatoes in the house too. Some of these are a mixture of the less sweet Japanese. I think there's a black treifle, I think it's called, in here as well. Some flowers on it. And the black cherry tomatoes back here are producing well. One of them's ripening. I've been spraying them today with some neem oil to help control the fungus. Again, lots of cherry tomatoes on there. This, I believe, is actually a big mama or a healthy gladiator. I've put these lingerie bags over the fruits because I really want to taste these and not let the birds have them. So hopefully in a week or two, these will be ready to eat. And this is my other black crim. And it's doing all right. I wish I had more fruit on it, but I'll take what I can get. These are some more San Marzano plants, so I really like to make sauce. It has some fruits on it right there. The other ones are just flowering now. These ones are kind of small. I think it's because they're out in the sun, and it seems that the sun here is very intense, so it tends to stunt tomato plants and pepper plants. By around 2 o'clock though, they're in shade, so perhaps they'll get enough sun to be, you know, a pretty good size. but these are nowhere near as big as I've seen the San Marzanos get. I think this is the Sweet 100 cherry tomato plant that was supposed to be planted where that Big Mama or Gladiator tomato plant is planted. it's doing okay in the bag, of course, because it's in a bag. It's not as big and robust as the other tomato plants, but it's nice to see how it's doing. It looks like it's producing just fine on a smaller plant. So I guess if you want an actual indeterminate cherry tomato plant, as long as you keep it some single stem, it's very possible to grow them on a patio. And this is a new plant that I'm trying. So this is the Big Mama. I guess I'll be able to verify whether that other one's a Big Mama or a Gladiator when this one grows up. So far it's growing well. Underneath here there's some potatoes, but I don't know if those potatoes will ever be growing because I don't know what I'm doing with potatoes. So we'll see. This one is another fresh salsa tomato. It looks quite different from the one in the other bed. This one's in a wine barrel planter and it's growing short and wide. The leaves are quite a bit bigger and the texture is very different than the one in the other planter. No tomatoes yet, but it just started flowering. It'll be interesting to see if these tomatoes taste any different or whether the size is different. I'm not sure why this one is this way versus the other one, but I do have an improvised shade cloth over it, and this one only gets sun in the morning. About 1 to 2 o'clock the house shades it, so anyhow, that's interesting. These are my newest tomatoes. These are green zebra, and I planted these over here to test whether tomatoes could be grown on the other side yard. So more of the green zebra over here. And then here I have my Roma tomato beds. There's 5 plants. They're doing all right. They actually get more sun because this area doesn't get shaded by the house in the afternoon. But I'm wondering if they're going to grow up stunted anyhow because of too much sun. So we'll see how it goes. So as far as caring for my tomatoes, they get watered twice a week on Monday and Thursday. They get watered by sprinklers or by drip irrigation for 10 minutes each day. So 2 days a week, 10 minutes each watering cycle. Every other week, I feed them fish emulsion. Right when they started having flowers, I gave them all some of the Epsom salt solution. And I treat them once a week with neem oil. So I've tried also the baking soda solution and the aspirin solution, and at least for me, I don't think those make much of a difference. And I think that either way, the neem oil and the baking soda solution, all they really do is slow whatever disease you have. For me, what I've seen, and it was too late by the time I applied it, is that mulching the ground is the best protection against the splashing water up on your plant and getting that mildew on your plants. And also, when you cut plant branches off from the mildew, you need to get rid of them right away and be careful not to crunch the leaves and spread the spores. I know that's very hard and I can't do it, but I try my best to do that. And that's all for my tomatoes. I guess it really wasn't as much as I thought, so this is probably just going to be one video. Until next time.